This is Shockwave News Live. You can find me online at shockwavenewslive.com and, of course, twitter.com/shockwavenews1. I'm also on Spreaker. That's spreaker.com/shockwavenews. And Anchor. That's anchor.fm/shockwavenews. And, of course, on YouTube, you can find me on YouTube at youtube.com/shockwavenewslive. Okay. Let's get into the news. Here's a disturbing article by naturalnews.com. That's naturalnews.com. Here is the article headline today from naturalnews.com. I just wanted to break this down and analyze this with you. It's a disturbing article. The headline reads, Antifa occupation of Seattle could just be the beginning of far worse scenarios across the U.S. Of course, let me preference this by saying, of course, with the shooting and killing of George Floyd, the riots, all the things that's been going on, riots and against thuggery, arson, treason, you name it, everything that's been going on, shoplifting, the crime, this Antifa and also BLM, Black Lives Matter, they have just gone on and on and on. They're an organization being funded through the back channels by George Soros. In case you don't know George Soros, you could look him up on Google sometime. He's a billionaire. He's had money way, way, way back. A little history on George Soros very quickly. George Soros got his money and his family. He is Jewish, and he betrayed his own Jewish roots and family back in World War II. So that's a little bit about him. He was a sellout, and he traded a lot of his Jewish roots and aspects, claiming he was German rather than Jewish, which he is. He could be German Jew, but he's still Jewish, and so he sold out his own people. That's something just to remember. And George Soros hates Americans. Again, if you go to YouTube.com, you can find there's lots of videos on George Soros, and there's one particular about him. His dislike, his distaste for America and the American people. He can't stand us. So there again, you have somebody that's willing to put up his billions of dollars to fund these Antifa and Black Lives Matter organizations so that they can go out and they can cause all kinds of destruction all over these cities in the United States. Okay, let's get into the article a little bit here. The article starts off, if you thought that the protesters and groups of Antifa weren't sophisticated enough to cause real harm, consider what could happen when powerful people support them. Just look at how far they've gotten in Seattle, a city whose mayor is fully on board with the efforts to control the six-block section of downtown. And again, Antifa and BLM, Black Lives Matter, in downtown Seattle, Washington, are controlling about six blocks. It's called an autonomous zone, or they're calling it CHAD, C-H-A-D, or CHAZ, rather, excuse me, C-H-A-S, C-H-A-Z. And they're controlling this zone, this area, six blocks downtown Seattle. Even the cops don't want to go in there because it's violent. Even with the weapons that we have now on the market, law enforcement, so on and so forth, they don't want to go in there because the mayor has basically told them, the liberal left-wing Democratic mayor has told them to just leave them alone. So you have a bunch of thugs scaring the living hell out of people living in downtown Seattle for a six-block area and being controlled by thugs, the thugs, Antifa, and Black Lives Matter. So the people are just terrified in there, but they're pretending everything's okay, life is good, blah, 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 blah. It's crazy as hell. So the article goes on, if you thought protesters and groups like Antifa were sophisticated enough to cause real harm, consider what could happen when powerful people support them. Just look at how far they've gotten in Seattle, a city whose mayor is fully on board with the efforts to control a six-block section of downtown. Dave Hodges of the Common Sense Show says that taking over a part of a major city, Antifa has committed an unmistakably act of war against the United States. And it's hard to argue with that. They've asked armed anarchists to join their efforts and even forced the police to abandon one of their police precincts. So, yeah, they took over a police precinct downtown in Seattle. So the police have abandoned that police precinct downtown in Seattle. The article goes on to say, those entering the area are greeted with handwritten message saying, you are now leaving the USA, implying they believe the area is some sort of country, even though there is no government that recognizes it. So again, they're handing people part of like a brainwashing scheme, if you will. A piece of paper said, welcome to the autonomous zone. You're now leaving the USA, United States of America. I mean, how insane is that? I can tell you how insane is that. The ludicrous leftists, the people that are the far left-wing wackos, if you will, believe in all this kind of crap. They do. They live, they breathe, and they die this type of crap. And they want to create a dystopia. And they think by burning down all these cities and everybody backs down that the cops and everybody will back down. Well, the problem is much deeper than that. The problem is organized chaos where these groups come in. They'll calm down eventually, but they'll threaten to start burning down all these other U.S. cities besides Seattle, Washington, downtown anyway. It's an inside job, and I've been saying this and saying this on my other podcast, and I've said it here before, that these groups that are funded by George Soros, it's all part of the bigger scheme and the bigger plan, which is to bring the USA, the United States of America, to its knees through any means possible in order to get Donald J. Trump, President Trump, out of office. They will do anything. If they have to sacrifice almost the entire world, practically, to do this, if they have to burn down every damn city in the United States to get President Trump out of office so he'll resign, they can get rid of him, they can set the White House on fire, any damn thing, these Black Lives Matter groups and these Antifa groups have been told that by George Soros. And he doesn't come right out and tell them, but he tells somebody that tells him. George Soros, you have to understand how these very rich elite people work. They don't work through like you and me. If I want something, I'll call you up. I'll send you a text on the phone. It's direct connect. We talk. Somebody like George Soros, there might be two or three or four people away from him so that they cannot tie his banking efforts and they can't tie the money that he's sending, he's laundering to these organizations. He's paying them literally to cause the chaos. So there might be two or three or four people in between a George Soros and in between Black Lives Matter and Antifa. So in other words, the money originally comes from George Soros, but he might hand it to somebody, hand it to another person that hands it to another person that finally hands it to somebody, gets it in the members of Black Lives Matter and Antifa. That's how that works. You know, that's how rich people work. They always want to be part of the shenanigans and they want to be part of the destruction, especially George Soros, the one that hates the United States so bad. But he does not want to be tied, I repeat, he does not want to be tied or connected to any of this crap going on over here, because he wants to keep it's all about reputation. He does not want to the world to see him as some evil, evil man that he is. So you have to keep that in mind. So let's continue, and I'll finish up the article here. They're making demands like releasing all inmates. These are criminals here in Seattle. They're making demands like releasing all inmates, disbanding of all police departments throughout the nation, and giving amnesty to every illegal immigrant, putting rent controls in place, creating a segregated medical care, and forsaking meat. It's pretty clear, but most of the clueless among us, this has little to do with racial equality. Many people fear this is only the beginning, and Dave Hodges, again, he had talked about this on his show, has a clear vision of what could happen next. Now that we've already seen public officials literally bowing down before these people, he says, with our main line of defense, the police, under attack in the aftermath, we will be ruled by warlords and eventually the blue helmets of the United Nations. So that's something to think about. I've had this discussion with many, many, many people before. They would say, okay, we want to bring in martial law. I said, no, you don't. They said, yes, we do. We want to bring in martial law. Let the military control these goons, and they'll take care of it. They'll wipe them out. Of course they will. Of course they will. Our military is trained in the best in the world. They'll walk right through an Antifa and BLM up there in the autonomous zone up there in Seattle, Washington. They'll just give up. They're not going to put up with anything. The military will tell them to drop their weapons. If they don't, they'll get shot and killed. It's just that simple. The military does not screw around or F around with people. That's the bottom line. They have a job to do, and they do it pretty damn well. Will this happen? Do they want the UN to come in here? Absolutely, positively not. The UN is made up of multiple countries. I want to say over 90 to 120 countries, if memory of last counted. There's lots and lots and lots of countries part of the United Nations, the UN. But you don't want the UN or the UN peacekeeping forces in here. These are people that have different values, and they don't care. They're not going to keep peace. Everywhere the UN goes, like third world countries, Africa, Haiti, and different places like that, most of the guys there, being from another country, they see a woman, they end up raping a woman and sometimes end up killing them, and then they just use the autonomy, in other words, the shield of the UN, just that name and being affiliated with them, to just say, oh, I don't know what you're talking about, it never happened, blah, blah, blah. So you don't want the UN peacekeeping forces here, and I have a feeling, like myself, that there are many, many hundreds of millions of patriots out there that as soon as the white helmets started coming in, what's going to happen is that they will end up shooting back. And that's something the UN is not very good at. And I'm going to tell you, the UN has tons and tons and tons of military power and might, care of the United States. We funded the UN for decades and decades and decades. But on the other hand, if we're not part of the UN, some of their troops, there's a few of them, the UK and Canada, that are halfway civilized and stuff like that, but most of their troops are very foreign, don't understand the culture, American culture over here. They don't understand now there's somebody fighting back. Not only fighting back, there's somebody shooting back. They're not going to know how to deal with that. UN would ever come here and this became urban warfare or hand-to-hand combat, they're going to be in for a hell of a battle. They'd have to bring in the big utility. They'd have to bring in the big utility, the big equipment, different things like that. And even that, they would be out for a hell of a fight. They wouldn't know what the hell to do. They would be in for a war. They never would forget that if the UN ever came to the United States and started trying to take over the U.S., the people, the U.S. patriots here in the United States would end up killing you know, hundreds of thousands of UN soldiers. I can tell you that, because there's not, we're not going to put up with that as a nation, nor are we going to put up with these renegades and these rioters and these people, these anarchists and these people that are just thugs and thieves and arsonists and just pure bums that are rioting in these cities. We're not going to put up with it anymore, and I know that, and there's other people out there that feel the same way. It's just that whoever's listening to this podcast, they're probably the secret majority, and you know who I'm talking about. They don't want to say anything because they're afraid. Well, I'll be your voice for you if that's the case. Say something loud, do something, prepare yourself. Just a little bit of humble suggestion and advice. Definitely get some extra food on hand. Get at least 2 weeks or a month. Start saving up for some food right now. I know things are trying to get back to normal, but I don't think they're ever going to be. Definitely see about getting yourself a firearm, something to protect yourself and your family. And have a place to go. If you have to stay in a big city, then prepare yourself. Prepare yourself and be able to fortify wherever you live, whether it's an apartment or it's a home in a big city or a suburb. Prepare yourself with extra locks, extra protection, reinforced doors so people can't just kick in your doors that easy. Same with your windows, so on and so forth. Because I don't think things are going to ever return back to 100%, folks. I'm just being very honest. They're going to keep the COVID scare going on throughout the summer because they think that the Antifa is taking center stage, and they don't want Antifa to take center stage. They just do not want that. They want everything cohesively to work together, and it's not working. It's not taking out President Trump. It's not working. So on that matter, so they're hoping that the Antifa and the Black Lives Matter do their job and can cause enough damage and destruction in order to get the president, so that we, the people, they want everybody that voted for President Trump to turn on him and force him to resign. Okay, this is Shockwave News Live. You can find me online at shockwavenewslive.com, twitter.com/shockwavenews1, spreaker.com/shockwavenews, and of course youtube.com, Shockwave News Live, and of course right here on Anchor. That's anchor.fm/shockwavenews. Okay, like, share, subscribe, stay safe out there, and watch your back. This is Shockwave News reporting live. I'm out of here.